Okay. Yeah, I'll remind you that if you're going to talk, talk loud enough for them to hear.
Okay.
Otherwise, they just see me stop paying attention and listen. Okay, we're probably all live. It's always ambiguous. It says, live now. Then it says, nah, now it's live. Then it says, now it's live. Okay, folks, now it's live. Welcome to number 6. I work on banana boat all night long. Daylight come and me one go home. All of the boatmen sing this song. Daylight come and me one go home. Day-o, day-o. Daylight come and me one go home. Day-o, day-o. Daylight come and me one go home. Come, Mr. Tallyman, tally me banana. Daylight come and me one go home. Come, Mr. Tallyman, tally me banana. Daylight come and me one go home. Day-o, day-o. Daylight come and me one go home. Day-o, day-o. Daylight come, me wanna go home. 6 foot, 7 foot, 8 foot bunch. Daylight come and me one go home. 8 foot, 10 foot, 12 foot bunch. Daylight come and me one go home. Day-o, day-o. Daylight come and me one go home. Day-o, day-o. Daylight come and me one go home. Now the mystery part of the song. Nobody understands this. Eh, eh, misete, 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 eh, oh. Daylight come and me one go home. Eh, eh, misete, 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 eh, oh. I think that's Latin for fungus, mushrooms. Daylight come and me one go home. I see big black hairy tarantula. Daylight come and me one go home. Climbing round banana branch, daylight come, me one go home. Well, I take my grips and I go to sea. Daylight come and me one go home. Then the banana see the last of me. Daylight come and me one go home. Day-o, day-o. Daylight come and me one go home. Day-o, day-o. Daylight come and me one go home. All right. We hope you sang your parts. Okay. during the sound check 40 minutes ago, the internet went, not the whole internet, but just midtel.net's internet. But we seem to be back again. Here is another song. This is a ridiculous song done by a fellow named Nervous Norvis, who had a string of hits just like this in the 50s. And there will be parts for you to sing along and bark along, okay? Back in the hills of old Kentucky, every farmer has a savage hunting dog. Them dogs are slim and sleek and plenty lucky, 'cause all day long they sleep just like a log. But when the moon comes up behind the mountain, they stir and snarl and bellow at the moon. Yes, their spurts get wild and bubbly like a fountain, 'cause they know they'll soon be running after Pooh. The wild dogs of Kentucky. The wild dogs of Kentucky. One more time now. Oh, 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 oh. Ooh. The wild, wild dogs of Kentucky. Now the grass is waving wildly in the meadow, to the tune of hounds a baying from afar. Mr. Coon is scared and ducking through the shadows. Oh, he wishes he was hiding on a star. All the hounds come racing wildly across the meadow. Mr. Coon is scared and racing for the trees. He's wishing he was hiding like a shadow. And their vampires, the devil's blood would freeze. I thought I knew this. The wild dogs of Kentucky. The wild dogs of Kentucky. Ooh, oh, oh. The wild, wild dogs of Kentucky. Now the piney woods are deep and dark and spooky, but hounds rush in where humans fear to tread. There's Pete and Pard and Pal and Spot and Lukey, and they won't rest till Coon's a lion's dead. The chase is long and hard and finally ended. They have treed poor Mr. Coon down by the stream. They're waiting for the shotgun man to end it, and they're yapping, snarling, yelping like a dream. Wild dogs of Kentucky. The wild dogs of Kentucky. We're going to do the extended version. Ooh, ooh, oh, oh. The wild, wild dogs of Kentucky.
It sounds
okay. Sound is okay.
Okay. That's all we want to know. Or at least it's not any worse than the sound I'm putting out, which is improving week by week. I'm getting my chops back. Okay. Ah, this song just popped in my head 3 weeks ago. I sing it, you know, once in the blue moons. I getting it back again. And lo and behold, one of these gentlemen, it seems to be like we're doing memorial music pages these days, and one of the Statler brothers just passed on, and that's a fooey. They're a fixture. Okay, and here's the song that I'm sure made them a fixture. Do I do this in C? Do I do this in B? D, E, C, I've been hearing you're concerned about my happiness. All that thought you're giving me is your conscience, I guess. Well, if I was in your shoes, I sure wouldn't worry none. While you do all that worrying, I've been up here having fun. Counting flowers on the wall, that don't bother me at all. Playing solitaire till dawn with a deck of 51. Smoking cigarettes and watching Captain Kangaroo. Now don't tell me I've nothing to do. Last night I got all dressed up like I was going to town. As long as I can dream, it's hard to slow this swinger down. So don't you worry about me, I'm really doing fine. You can find me over. I'm up here having quite. I thought I knew this one too. You know, I can goof around. Okay, I'm going to take advantage of having interrupted myself to move where my feet are sitting, so I stop making the camera do that. You can find me up here always having quite a time, counting flowers on the wall. That don't bother me at all. Playing solitaire till dawn with a deck of 51. Smoking cigarettes and watching Captain Kangaroo. Now don't tell me I've nothing to do. Oh, it's good to see you. I must go. I know I look a fright. Anyway, my eyes are not accustomed to this light, and my boots are not accustomed to this hard concrete. So I must hurry to my room to make my day complete. Counting flowers on the wall, that don't bother me at all. Playing solitaire till dawn with a deck of 51. Smoking cigarettes and watching Captain Kangaroo. Now don't tell me I've nothing to do. Oh, don't tell me I've nothing to do. Who doesn't love that? All right. And now, people. A good many years ago, I always have to tell Sally it was before I knew her, although not before she was a gleam in her mother's eye. And I was coming back from, 20 year high school reunion, and reconnected with a flame, an old flame. She never had anything to do with me.
You're getting in trouble.
I'm getting in trouble here. I'm talking too long. But anyway, I heard this song about old flames, among other things. This is... Oh, phooey. Behave. It was just the right time to come upon this song. It's been down there parked in my DNA ever since. Do you know how long it's been since my 20-year reunion? Last night as I lay sleeping, I dreamt of days gone by. Me mind being bent on rambling, to Ireland I did fly. I stepped on board a vision, I wandered with a till at last I came to anchor by the cross at Spancil Hill. It being the 23rd of June, the day before the fair, all Ireland's sons and daughters and friends assembled there. Young and old, the brave and bold, their duty to fulfill. At the parish church at Toomey, but a mile from Spancil Hill. Went to see me neighbors just to hear what they might say. The old ones all were dead and gone, young ones turning gray. I met with Taylor Quigley, he's bold as ever still. And he used to saw me britches when I lived in Spancil Hill. Mm-hmm. fly on visit. To me first and only love. She's white as any lily, gentle as a dove. She threw her arms around me, crying, Johnny, I love you still. As she's Nell, the farmer's daughter, and the pride of Spancil Hill. I dreamt she knelt and kissed me, as she did in days of yore, crying, Johnny, you're surely joking, as so many a time before. The cock he crew the morning, and he crew both loud and shrill. I woke in California, many miles from Spancil Hill.
On your background.
Oh, the background. Well, speaking of Irish songs, the background, the foreground, that what I'm looking at is, you know, about inch an hour snow, April 26th.
Yeah.
Sheesh. And welcome to the new normal in weather. Now then, what you see over my shoulder is kind of the view out of our kitchen window in West Cork, outside the town of Skull. And those little white dots, those are sheep. We get to see sheep. And that would be Dunmanis Bay on that side. And if we were there, we'd be looking over that way. We would see a little bit of the Atlantic Ocean. And that's pretty cool, and it's nice that Sally got us a poster of it, because we don't know when we're going to see it next in person. Because. Why because? You know why because. Oh, Sally, my dear, with you I'd be straying. Oh, Sally, my dear, with you I'd be straying. Ah, you foolish young man, you don't know what you're saying. To me whack-faldie I do, and a whack-faldie eh. You may sing the whack-faldies. Oh, Sally, my dear, with you 'tis you I'd be wooing. Oh, Sally, my dear, 'tis you I'd be wooing. Ah, you foolish young man, you don't know what you're doing. To me whack-faldie I do, and a whack-faldie eh. Oh, Sally, my dear, 'tis you I'd be kissing. Oh, Sally, my dear, 'tis you I'd be kissing. Ah, you foolish young man, you don't know what you're missing. To me whack-faldie I do, and a whack-faldie eh. Oh, Sally, my dear, with you I'd be mating. Oh, Sally, my dear, if with you I'd be mating. Ah, you foolish young man, well then why are you waiting? To me whack-faldie I do, and a whack-faldie ay. Learnt off a Pete Seeger record, really. Well, he had four kids. What do you want? Huh? They come from somewhere. This is a family-oriented show. Well, where do you think families come from? Sorry. Okay, something else popped back in my mind. It's sillier, and flowers on the wall. And it, I said, I bet I can. I just ran the words off. I'm going to be reading this one. Why not? Why would I not? Okay, let's see if what key we might be in. Okay. The old timers. Back at this place, I sang outside of Buffalo for 5 years during the 80s, 70s and 80s. The old timers. These guys were in their 70s, 45 years ago. They haven't, never mind. I'm 73 myself. I must be one of those old timers. And here's the song they thought was just a cat's, part of the cat. They say don't go on Wolverton Mountain if you're looking for a wife. Clifton Clowers has a pretty young daughter, but he's mighty handy with a gun or a knife. Her tender lips, sweeter than honey. I want her. And Wolverton Mountains protects her there. The bears and the birds tell Clifton Clowers if a stranger should enter there. All of my dreams are on Wolverton Mountain. I want his daughter for my wife. I'll take my chances, climb that mountain. Though Clifton Clowers, he might take my life. Her tender lips are sweeter than honey. Wolverton Mountain protects her there. The bears and the birds tell Clifton Clowers if a stranger should venture there. I'm going up on Wolverton Mountain. It's too lonesome down here below. It's just not right to hide his daughter from the man who loves her slow. I don't care about Clifton Clowers. I'm gonna climb up on his mountain. I'm gonna find the girl in love. I don't care about Clifton Clowers. I'm gonna climb up on his mountain. I don't care about Clifton Clowers. I'm gonna find the girl I love. I'm gonna climb up on his mountain. I'm gonna climb up.
Mother used to sing that song.
Okay. See, that wasn't as some, at least one person out there had heard of it. Okay. What's next there? Oh, yes, this is nice. We're going to take this off.
Brothers Four.
Didn't think they were that hokey. I consider that a hokey song. Not that it isn't pleasant to sing. Hungry feeling came o'er me stealing, and the mice were squealing in my prison cell. And the old triangle went jingle jangle all along the banks of the Royal Canal. to begin the morning. The warder bawling, get out of bed and clean up yourself. The old triangle went jingle jangle all along the banks of the Royal Canal. Now the screw was peeping, the lag was sleeping, and he lay there weeping for his gal Sal. And the old triangle went jingle jangle all along the banks of the Royal Canal. On a fine spring evening, the lag lay dreaming, and the seagulls wheeling high above the wall. The old triangle went jingle jangle all along the banks of the Royal Canal. Ah, the wind was sighing, day was dying as the lag lay crying in his prison cell. The old triangle went jingle jangle all along the banks of the Royal. In the female prison, there are 70 women, and it's all there with them. I should like to dwell. Then the old triangle could go jingle jangle all along the bank of the Royal Canal.
I think it's 2 inches an hour now.
It's smaller, but more of them. We're speaking of the white stuff. A demure lady of our acquaintance. If I talk about demure ladies, you know that I learned my social mores in the 50s. And we thought, you know, the age, chivalry was still there. Open doors for ladies. But it comes back on you. Because, you know, as presidential timber, speaking of old white guys, I'll tell you when it gets you. It gets you when, like, a 45-year-old woman holds the door for you. Padoom! And she asked for this here tune. No, she didn't ask for this tune. She asked for a really kind of over-the-top, well, excitable boy. Warren Zevon. I like that song, but I don't sing it. This one is so much more socially acceptable. God. Okay, I guess I'd do that without no capo. Even if I may be talking a lot, we're only halfway through here. I'm getting down my list. I'm going to have to punt. Are you going to have to put in requests? As I'm sure Popeye might have said. Remember to tune your D string up after you do something in drop D. It's much more awkward playing in a band and you can't hear yourself that well. You know something's off, but you don't know what it is. Everybody's looking around saying, who's hitting wrong notes?
It was me.
It was I. Roland was a warrior. From the land of the midnight sun, where the Thompson gun for hire, fighting to be done. The deal was made in Denmark on a dark and stormy day, and he set out for Biafra to join the bloody fray. Through 66 and 7, they fought the Congo wars with their fingers on their triggers, knee-deep in gore. Through the days and nights they battled the Bantu to their knees. They killed to earn their living and to help out the Congolese. Roland the Thompson gunner, Roland the Thompson gunner. His comrades fought beside him, Van Owen and the rest. But of all the Thompson gunners, Roland was the best. So the CIA decided they wanted Roland dead. That son of a bitch, Van Owen, shot off Roland's head. Roland the Thompson gunner, Roland the Thompson gunner. Killing, killing, killing in another Eastern war, but it don't lay down for no man till it evens up the score. And they still see his headless body stalking through the night, while the muzzle flash of Roland's Thompson gun, by the muzzle flash of Roland's Thompson. Continent for the man who done him in, and he caught him in Mombasa in a bar room drinking gin. Roland named his Thompson gun, he did not speak a word, but it blew Van Owen's body from there to Johannesburg. Roland the Thompson gunner, Roland the headless Thompson gunner. The eternal Thompson gunner, still wandering through the night. Now it's 10 years later, still keeps up the fight. Palestine, Lebanon, Ireland,
Berkeley. Patty Hearst heard the burst of Roland's Thompson gun and bought it.
Well, that brought on a request for Sweeney Todd.
That would be from an engineer, surely. Okay, I'm just going to say that is one of the most bizarre ending lines in any song I have ever had or song or heard. I looked her up. Seems that, Patty Hearst may actually have been victimized and not some, revolutionary little rich girl or something. And it seems that since she got out, and Jimmy Carter let her out, like 12 years early, and he doesn't pardon people like some people might, and seems like she's led an exemplary life ever since then. Good works and good times, and so that's just what it is. Okay, so do we? Who wanted to hear Sweeney Todd?
Gail Hellman.
Yeah. Okay. Yes. Okay. If it's not from RPI, it's from Buffalo. Let me see. I may just remember that. Since we're going dark, okay, I'm going to have a little water, and we'll see if I can just roll this out. Otherwise, I'll be horribly embarrassed, and it'll be Gail Hellman's fault. I just probably have to launch into it and hope it spills off the synapses. In Fleet Street, that's in London town, when good King Charlie wore the crown, there lived a man of great renown. 'Twas Sweeney Todd the barber. He, one shave from him and you'd want no more. You'd feel his razor sharp. Bang, wallop, you'd tumble through the floor and wake up singing, playing, strumming a harp. All together now. Sweeney Todd the barber. By God, he were better than the plague. Sweeney Todd the barber. I'll polish him off, he used to say. His clients through the floor. His clients through the floor would slope, but he had no fear of the hangman's rope. Dead men can't talk with a mouth full of soap, cried Sweeney Todd the barber. Now, underneath the shop, it's true, but where the bodies tumbled through, there lived a little widow who loved Sweeney Todd the barber. She made her living by selling pies. Her meat pies were a treat, chock full of meat, and such a size, for she was getting the meat from Mr. Sweeney Todd the barber. I know what you were thinking. By God, you were better than the plague. Sweeney Todd the barber. I'll polish him off, he used to say. And it's many the poor young orphan lad, who the first hot meal that he ever had was a great meat pie baked out of his dad from Sweeney Todd the barber. Now, it was Saturday night in old Sweeney's Todd's shop, and the customers sat in a row. And Sweeney stood shaving some poor mug whilst his sweetheart baked pies down below. First a swell took the chair, ha ha, my good man, just a shave and a perfume, the shampoo, for I've just got engaged. Sweeney pressed on the knob and said, there, now that's all fallen through.
Next to book, Michael sat with his mouth full of soap. He says, they're all back on favourites today, so I bet I'll go down. Sweeney said, that you will. And he did. He went down straight away. But what rotten luck! The trap went and stuck. For the inge he'd forgotten to grease. And a customer ran out of the shop, flying down the stairs, down the street, running away, crying, help, help, police, police, help, help. But no police arrived. Police hadn't been invented yet. But up ran the bold Bow Street runners. Hurrah! And Sweeney was forced to let many a pie burn. They dragged him to quad, and next day Sweeney Todd was sentenced to be switched off at Tyburn. And there is Gibbet, the hounds in his chains, and they say that a fat old crow made a nest in Sweeney Todd's whiskers, and he sang as he swang to and fro. Sweeney Todd the barber, by God, he were better than the plague. Sweeney Todd the barber, oil polish him off, he used to say. And the men folk called him back from the grave, crying, wake up, Sweeney! We want a shave! And the ladies all want a permanent wave from Sweeney Todd the barber.
Everyone is safe from him right now. The next request is just as dark. Yeah. Tom Dooley.
Oh my God. All right, who's that from?
Don Reed.
Okay. Okay, yes. And
hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Hang down your head and cry. Hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Poor boy, you're bound to die. This time tomorrow, reckon where I'd be. Hadn't have been for Grayson, I'd have been in Tennessee. Tom Dooley, hang down your head and cry. Hang down your head, Tom Dooley, poor boy, you're bound to die. Tom Dooley, filled with grief and strife. You killed poor Laurie Foster, and then you took her life. Hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Hang down your head and cry. Hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Poor boy, you're bound to die. This time tomorrow, I reckon where I'll be, down in the lonesome valley, hanging from a white oak tree. Hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Hang down your head and cry. Hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Poor boy, you're bound to die. Poor boy, you're bound.
And with that, you know, I learned it from the Kingston Trio. Okay, where are we? We have a quarter of an hour. Is there any sign of Curtis Phillips or John Luther?
I'm not sure.
No. Okay, well, then I'll go another week on House at Pooh Corner.
And that means I have nothing less to say goodbye.
Well, there you go. Here's, this has got a chorus that's repeated many times. I can't remember for pure if I did this a week or two ago. It doesn't matter. Only Michael Cooney was bound to never split an infinitive or perform the same song twice in the front of the same human being. From state to state, he always had something different. Of course, he knew enough songs that he'd get away with that. I knew a lot. I knew a bunch in my day. But now I only know four or five, so I'm starting from the top of my list again.
Joan and Sarah are here.
Oh, okay. Then, we'll take a shot at Winnie the Pooh here. And, you know, it's a nice song to have back, so I'll put it again in a month when I have it down even colder, but you've been asking for it for 3-4 weeks. Kenny Loggins inexcusably did not by name mention the 3-acre woods. I never really knew what that was about. Christopher Robin and I walked alone under branches lit up by the moon, causing questions to Owl and Eeyore, and the days disappeared all too soon. I wandered much farther today than I should, can't find my way to the 3-acre wood. Help me if you can, gotta get back to the house at Pooh Corner by 1. You'd be surprised, there's a lot to be done. Count all the bees in the hive, chase all the clouds in the sky, back to the days of Christopher Robin and Pooh. Winnie the Pooh doesn't know what to do, got a honey jar stuck on his nose. Came to me asking help and advice, and from here no one knows where he goes. I sent him to ask of the owl if he's there, how you loosen a jar from the nose of a bear. Help me if you can, I gotta get back to the house at Pooh Corner by 1. You'd be surprised, there's a lot to be done. Count all the bees in the hive, chase all the clouds from the sky, back to the days of Christopher Robin and Pooh. Sent him to ask of the owl if he's there, how you loosen the jar from the nose of a bear. Help me if you can, I've got to get back to the house at Pooh Corner by 1. You'd be surprised, there's a lot to be done. Count all the bees in the hive, chase all the clouds from the sky, back to the days of Christopher Robin, back to the days of Christopher Robin, back to the days of Pooh.
way too young to have been at the rolls, but she's angling for it because with 7 minutes left, she asks for American pie, which takes half an hour.
What? Again? I've had people try to tell me that the Edmund Fitzgerald is actually half an hour long on the original record. It's not. It's, you know, 10, 7. More than they usually. I'm let me see. I don't think it's over there. I probably want lyrical hints if I'm going to attempt American Pie. That's the request from me coming from the farthest away at the moment. It's in this pile. Is this not entertaining the hell out of you? Watching, not even watching.
Your rear end?
No. Look, I'll tell you what. I'll just wing it. Maybe I can only remember 4.5 verses. You'll be relieved. We'll put this out in honor of Barr and Bennington. T.J. Carmody's, and where he would get on top of the bar with his two sons, who were both bigger than he was.
And all wearing dresses.
No, that was early after the parade. They got rid of the dresses later. That was the Bennington. Don't distract me. They weren't wearing dresses. I hate to. I hate to contradict my wife over the internet. I'm in for it now, boys. I won't say I'm going to get it tonight. Uh oh.
No, you won't.
She's quoting Cher now. A long, long time ago, I can still remember when that music used to make me smile. I knew if I had my chance. Nah, come on, I've declared I'm just gonna wing it.
Okay.
I'll ask for a cue if I need it. I could make those people dance and maybe they'd be happy for a while. But February made me shiver with every paper I delivered. Bad news on the doorstep. I couldn't take one more step. And I don't remember if I cried when I read about his widowed bride. But something touched me deep inside the day music died. So bye bye, Miss American Pie. Drove my Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry. Good old boys were drinking whiskey and rye, singing, this will be the day that I die. This will be the day that I die. Did you write the book of love? You have faith in God above, and does the Bible tell you so? Do you believe in rock and roll? Music save your mortal soul, and would you teach me how to dance real slow? Well, I know that you're in love with him. Saw you dancing in the gym. You both kicked off your shoes. I really did that rhythm and blues. I was a lonely teenage blonking buck with a pink carnation and a pickup truck, but I knew I was out of luck the day the music died. And we were singing bye-bye, Miss American Pie. Drove my Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry. Good old boys is drinking whiskey and rye, singing, this will be the day that I die. This will be the day that I die. We've been on our own. Moss grows fat on a rolling stone, but that's not how it used to be. Jester sang for the king and queen in a coat he borrowed from James Dean, and a voice that came from you and me. While the king was looking down, the jester stole his thorny crown, no verdict was returned. Courtroom was adjourned, and while Lennon read a book on Marx, we sat dirges in the dark and quartets practiced in the park. The day the music died, and we were singing Bye Bye Miss American Pie. Get it to the levee, but the levee was dry. The good old boys was drinking whiskey and rye, singing, this will be the day that I die. This will be the day that I die. Helter skelter in the fallout swell. Days flew out in the summer swelter. The brush was a fallout shelter, 8 miles high and falling fast. Who says I can't phrase? Fell right down upon the grass. The players tried for a forward pass. The jester on the sideline in a cast. Halftime there was sweet perfume. The jester played our marching tune. Yeah, we all got up to dance, but we never got the chance. The players tried to take the field. Marching band refused to yield. Do you recall what was the deal? The day the music died, it was singing Bye Bye Miss American Pie. Drove my Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry. Good old boys are singing whiskey and rye, singing, this will be the day that I die. This will be the day that I die.
All right, first verse of the next, first line of the next verse.
I was answering a question. Did you sing
the
laugh with the wife
then?
What?
Met a girl who sang the blues. Asked her for some happy news. She just smiled and turned away. I went to the secret store, where I heard the music play before. The man there said the music couldn't play. And in the streets, children screamed. Lovers sighed and poets dreamed. But not a word was spoken. Church bells were all broken. And the three men I admire the most, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, all caught a Learjet for the coast. The way the music died. Bye-bye, Miss American Pie. Drove my Chevy to the levee, but the levee was dry. Good old boys were singing whiskey and rye, singing, this will be the day that I die. This will be the day that I die.
Australia.
Let's do this again next week. 6 o'clock, same time, same place. And if you would like to pass the notice along or share it on your Facebook stream pages, perhaps millions of people will attend and we'll lose our heretofore coziness. Coziness forever. Now, while I fumble around, clicking all the things that I have to click to get this thing to fade out gracefully, you might just look over Dunmanis Bay over my shoulder, and may we all meet there by this time next year.